Hi everyone, my name is Esther and this video is part of the series How to Deal with Crises. And before we start, of course, please read your Bible because with this, change is going to come. Truly it is, if you read it. So today is part two of the series How to Deal with Crises, with crisis in your life. And yesterday I discussed why it is important to only look upon Jesus and not to look at your crisis. And maybe you've heard that video. If not, you can check it out. And but today we're gonna discuss what's next. Maybe you've made in your heart a decision. Well, if a crisis will hit me, or maybe you are in the middle of a crisis right now, hopefully not, then you can say to yourself, okay, what's next? What is next to do and how to deal with crises? And believe me, I do not like steps or that you need to take steps in a chronological order, because the Lord will guide you, and He will not guide you with steps, but He will guide you from your heart and with love. But I will just say the next step is, because this is a part of a series, so this is part two. That's why I'm saying the next step can be. So anyway, the next step that you can do is ask for wisdom, because wisdom is very, very important. And most of the time when crisis hits you, you will blur, or most of the time you will panic, or fear will attack you because you are in the middle of a crisis. And besides, it is very important to ask for wisdom. It's equally important to take authority over your emotions. Because if you let fear out and if you start panicking, you cannot hear a sound wisdom. You cannot hear what the Lord is telling you. So I will do another video, another series, and I think it's a long series, about how to take authority. But today I will just tip it on lightly and will say, and I will let you know how I do it, how I did it, because I'm not in a crisis right now. So anyway, when crisis hit me, when it did, I always made a choice. I will kneel down and say, Lord, you are my Lord. You are number one. And then I will say to myself, and I take authority, or I speak it. I will say, emotions, you will shut up. My ears are open for the Lord. My ears are open for heaven. And I will download every kind of form of wisdom that I need. And then I will say, Holy Spirit, guide me, because you are beautiful. You are wisdom. And Lord, I love you so much. Help me with this crisis. Help me to guide me. So to get angry with the Lord, because sometimes people will get angry with the Lord within the crisis, is the stupidest thing you can do, because the Lord is not responsible for the crisis. Better yet, he can help you to guide you through the crisis. And I will, of course, I have a huge, good, very good verse, very good scripture, and that is in James 1 from verse 5, and I will speak it out loud. If any of you lack wisdom, that's me, especially in crisis. No, that's not what it says. It says, if any of you lack wisdom, let him ask of God, that give it to all men liberally and upbraid it not, and it shall be given to him. Wow, so here it says, if you lack, you can ask and he will give it to you. But there is a big but, and we're gonna read it, what this but is. But in verse 6, let him ask in faith, nothing wavering. For he that wavereth is like a wave of the sea driven with the wind and tossed. 7. For let not that man think that he shall receive anything of the Lord. And we don't need this. We need to receive. In verse 5, a double-minded man is unstable in all his ways. So, like how I did it. Well, I just made an example, sorry for my stuttering. But you just take authority over your emotions and you say to yourself, I will not waver, I will not be tossed around with all the things that happen around me. I am stable in Christ and He will guide me through wisdom. He will give it to me. And Lord, I trust you. I trust you that you give me wisdom. And that's the next thing that you can do, because man, in a crisis you need wisdom, especially when a loved one has passed away. Maybe you have tried to raise them up from the dead, but the person is still dead anyway. You need wisdom for how you can, what you can do next, and what kind of move you can do. Or maybe you are in a fight with your spouse. Then you need wisdom as well, how you need to act and how you need to handle. Maybe you need to humble yourself. It will be another series. But crisis, you have all different kinds of crisis. Maybe you have a crisis on your job. Especially on your job, you need wisdom. And wisdom, the Greek word for wisdom is sophia, if I pronounce it correctly. But wisdom, this wisdom is a broad wisdom. It's not only the wisdom how the Lord had made the heaven and the earth. No, He will give you also wisdom how to act with other people, how to interact with them, or even how to interpret your dreams and visions you have received from the Lord. Or you can have management skills if you have a problem on your job. This wisdom is so broad. It's wide. It's wisdom on every occasion you need. So if you are in a crisis, first choose Jesus. Always choose these Jesus, not only in your crisis. But the second thing is ask for wisdom and take authority over all those panic and fear emotions, because otherwise it will blur you and you will not hear correctly from the Lord because you are in panic. And panic will not help you. It will give you headache. It will give you big, huge eyes because you're crying. You're crying out loud, and it won't help you. Seriously, it won't help you. So tomorrow we're gonna discuss further, and we are going to discuss how to deal further with this. How you can feel blessed and know that you are blessed even within a crisis. But that will be tomorrow. See you tomorrow. Okay, bye.